Hello students, welcome to Commercial Arithmetic class. I'm Professor Sushila Deep Shetty and today we will begin with the first unit of your even semester Commercial Arithmetic, that is Simple Interest. So from today's video you will be understanding what is interest, what is simple interest and what is the formula used to calculate simple interest, and some of the few important notes which will be useful for our further calculation of problems. So first let us understand what is interest. So now we can see in day-to-day activities or in any business there is a practice of borrowing a money, and according to the needs of people they borrow money from someone who is capable of lending. But this borrowing is at a certain cost. Suppose now I am borrowing 100 rupees from a person X, then he will tell me that after 1 month I have to pay a cost for asking or borrowing 100 rupees for him. So he might say you have to pay 10% of whatever amount you want to borrow. So if I'm borrowing 100 rupees, then 10% of it will be 10 rupees. So at the end of 1 month, I have to pay 110 rupees to the person X. So here 100 is the amount that I initially borrowed, and the 10 rupees extra is nothing but the interest. So you can see in many banks or in day-to-day life, in Kannada they'll be saying baddi vyavahara. So all this is based on interest. So this is very common notation. As a BCom students, I hope you guys are familiar with the word interest. So suppose a interest is generally quoted in terms of 100 per year. So now let me give a simple example. If a interest is quoted as 5% per annum. Always remember per annum is denoted by P dot A, which is abbreviated as per annum. So suppose interest is quoted at 5% per annum, it means that for borrowing rupees 100 for 1 year, the interest payable is 5 rupees. Here 5 rupees is nothing but the interest amount and 5 is nothing but the rate of interest. So suppose a person borrows 8000 for 2 years and pays an interest of 1600, then the total amount payable is 9600, because initially he pays 8000, then the interest is 1600. So together when you add it will be 9600. So here this is a basic concept of interest. So in calculation of interest, what all notations we require is the principal, which is denoted by P, the period for which the amount is borrowed or it is given for rent, and it will be usually in terms of years and it is denoted by T, and capital R is nothing but the rate of interest. So now let us see what is simple interest. So it is a charge paid for the use of borrowed money and depends on the sum borrowed, time for which it is borrowed and the rate of interest. So remember, it is the interest for the original principal for the entire period of borrowing. So suppose you are taking 100 rupees for 10 years, then you have to pay interest for the initial amount, that is for 100 rupees for all the 10 years. So this is the concept of simple interest, and here note that interest on interest is not charged. So the formula for simple interest is given as S dot I is nothing but simple interest. So simple interest is equal to PTR by 100, where P is principal, T is period, which is in terms of years as said, and R is rate of interest. So please remember this formula, that is the formula for simple interest, which is PTR by 100. So this was the formula for interest. Now let us see the formula for amount repayable, and it is given as P is equal to P plus SI or P plus interest, where P is the principal and I is the interest. So we know the formula, which is P plus the interest formula is PTR by 100. So now in the next step we can take P as common, which will be 1 plus TR by 100. So the amount can be calculated as principal amount plus the interest. So now please remember this note. So the note says, when a sum doubles itself, then TR is equal to 100. So this TR is equal to 100 when the sum doubles itself. For example, here P is 100. We want the sum to be doubled. Then we have to take TR as 100. So the interest will be 100. So we got interest as 100. So what will be the amount, which will be principal plus interest? Now principal is 100. We got the interest as also 100. So amount at the end will be 200. We can see the amount is doubled. That is, initially principal was 100. Now it is 200. So whenever you want the amount to be doubled, we have to take TR is equal to 100. Similarly, when you want the sum or the amount to be 3 times more, then TR should be taken as 200. So here take TR is equal to 200. So P is 100. So 100 and 100 will get cancelled. So interest will be 200. So when you substitute it in the amount, it will be 100 plus 200 is interest. So we got the amount as 300. So initially our principal amount was 100. Now it is 300. You can see it is 3 times more. So when you want a sum to triple itself, then you have to take TR to be 200. Similarly, if you want a sum to be 4 times more than itself, then you have to take TR as 300, and so on. So similarly, when a sum becomes 1.5 times of itself, then TR should be 50. So take P as 100, TR is 50. So simple interest will be 50. So the amount repayable will be principal amount plus interest. Interest we got as 50. So the amount will be 150 rupees. So we can see the amount is becoming half times more than the initial amount. So in such cases, we have to take TR as 100. Similarly, when the sum becomes 1.25 times of itself, then TR becomes 25. So please remember these notes. It will be useful for calculating 2 marks problems. And remember this formula of simple interest, that is PTR by 100, which we will be using in the next class for calculating problems. So that's for today's classes. Thank you.